Hey YouTube, this is Print Practical. Today, we're gonna design some print in place ball bearings that are completely 3D printed. Let's go. So this turned out okay. It's still got the supports on the back of the balls here, so I'm gonna work on removing that. Overall though, it's definitely a little loose, which means the tolerance that I had for the balls is a little too high, so I'm probably gonna reprint it out, but let me remove the supports and we'll give it a few spins and see how it feels. So I have most of the support material off now. There's very loose in there. So I'm gonna have to change that tolerance a little bit. But overall it does spin, which is good. Let's change the tolerance and print out another one, see if we can improve on this a little bit. I want it to be tight. But I still want it to spin pretty freely. I have some projects that I want to use these in. So I think I found the problem with my tolerance. If I go back to look at my sketch here. Here's my tolerance, but it's being 0.6 millimeters on both sides, which is really a tolerance of 1.2 millimeters, which is way too high. So I'm just going to divide that by 2 so that I get the real tolerance that I wanted. There we go. So I'm going to reprint this out. All right, we're back. Here's the old bearing. Super loosey-goosey. And here is the newly printed bearing. It's very tight. So I'm gonna see if I can remove these supports and then I'm gonna work it in a little bit, see if we can make this spin like a normal bearing. So we removed most of the support material here and it loosened up a decent amount. There's like a little tiny bit of slop, but that's good. And it seems to spin pretty well. So I would call this one a success. And I'm going to use this design in my future projects. So there you go, 3D printed, print in place, ball bearing. If you like this content, check out my other videos and subscribe to the channel. Thanks.